My name is Barry. I am a teacher from a primary school in the west of Ireland, and I teach the Irish primary school curriculum. I'm author of Mission to the Moon 1, Fly Me to the Moon, as part of the Aerospace in-class learning scenario. The topic of my learning scenario is the makeup of rockets and how we use these to fly to the moon. This topic is applicable for students aged 9 plus and is made up of two lessons. Throughout this learning scenario, students get to explore the various forces that have influenced the rocket's construction and flight with the following main outcomes. Lesson 1 is a discovery discussion-based lesson where children's knowledge and understanding of aerodynamics is explored. And Lesson 2 is a project-based lesson and assesses children's ability to bring their learning from the previous lesson to the practical application and construction in this lesson.
My name is Anna Zivkovic, and I teach English as a foreign language at a primary school in Niš, Serbia. I'm the author of Aerospace in Class learning scenario titled Designing Your Moon Base. This learning scenario links learning English with learning about the moon and about living in space. The students will be able to express their creativity by drawing the base and optionally by creating a 3D model according to that sketch using recyclable materials. By writing a short description of the moon settlement, students will revise and expand the vocabulary about rooms, furniture, appliances, and practice the use of prepositions of place.
My name is Selçuk Yusuf Arslan. I'm from Ankara, capital of Turkey. I teach computer science in a secondary school and a high school. I am one of the lead teachers in Aerospace in Class project. The topic of my learning scenario is Hack the Moon. It was prepared for students aged between 8 and 12. This learning scenario aims to teach the basic features of the moon in a fun way. An interdisciplinary approach was adopted in this learning scenario, which includes subjects such as physics, coding, biology, geography, and 3D design. At the end of the course, students will have learned the features of the moon and reached intended learning outcomes such as 3D oxygen tank and an educational game.
Hi, my name is Aleksandra Pešić. I'm a teacher from the primary school in Niš, Serbia, and I teach computer science. I'm the author of the Lunar Road Trip Aerospace in Class learning scenario. This learning scenario aims at stimulating students to think critically and to illustrate the importance of scientific research for space exploration, such as for the exploration of the moon. Through creativity and innovation, students will be able to learn and test what life and driving on the moon's surface look like.
Materials provided were clear, concise, and very easy to use in the learning scenario. Within the lessons themselves, the children responded very well to these videos, which provided ample opportunity for peer and class discussion.
It can be said that many skills needed by students have developed with this learning scenario. For instance, they collaborated through game-based learning. They solved problems following the instructions they were given. They also use their creativity in both the 3D oxygen tank and the educational game design, and they try to implement design thinking.
The students participating in the learning scenario received a lot of great benefits, such as critical thinking, problem solving, collaboration, getting students to work together, achieving compromise, and getting the best possible results from solving a problem. Furthermore, they worked on their do-it-yourself building and testing a moon rover with a robotic arm.
Aerospace was an area I was very interested in, so I am very lucky to have been involved in this project. The content of the Airbus Foundation Discovery Space Resources is really high quality. I also gained in-depth knowledge of the aerospace field while designing and implementing the learning scenario, and I think I was helpful in promoting positive change in students' development.
The students can think critically about claims and facts in the scientific field. Moreover, they are now able to demonstrate the importance of scientific research on how to live on other planets.
After the learning scenario, they were more eager to learn English because it is one of the languages that the astronauts use for communication in space. This learning activity really boosted their motivation.
They were very eager to show off their own creations to the class, and this provided a great opportunity for peer assessment. The construction was by far the highlight of the lessons. Pupils really engaged in this and came up with some lovely designs. This is one area that may require a little more time, as I had to assist the lesser able pupils during the lesson.
I was really impressed by some of their works of art, and I think they have invested a great deal of time and energy in this homework. Some of them even went further and made short videos with background music, and this was not obligatory.
My top three pieces of advice to teachers who want to implement an aero learning scenario in their classrooms. Use tools like online platforms to prepare the students, use animated videos to introduce a new lecture, and include your colleagues that teach related subjects. And don't forget to have fun!